हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू ईपीजी पाठशाला। आई एम डॉक्टर राजेश गौतम फ्रॉम डॉक्टर हरि सिंह गौर विश्वविद्यालय सागर मध्य प्रदेश। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट अ मॉड्यूल एंटाइटल्ड एवोल्यूशनरी हिस्ट्री ऑफ लाइफ under the paper entitled Human Population Genetics. So students, let us see what we are going to learn from this module. You might be knowing how our earth is formed, but here again I will tell you the formation of earth. And after formation of earth, how life originated on our planet, then I will tell you what are the theories of creation of life or origin of life. So first we will discuss about theory of divine or special creation, then theory of spontaneous generation, then theory of cosmogonic origin. To know further, we will also know what is theory of eternity and theory of catastrophism. And lastly, but not least, we will also know about geological time scale. You might be knowing, as I told you earlier, the life on earth was originated by the process of complex physical and chemical reactions. When earth came into existence, it was hot. The formation of earth crust has taken billions of years. By the combination of oxygen and hydrogen atom, water was formed, which is an essential part of life. Gradually, continuous thunder and lightning, raining, has created environment for emergence of super matter, having consciousness from unique combination of simple matter and energy. You might be knowing that atom of carbon, nitrogen, hydrogen, oxygen, phosphorus and some other elements combined and given shape to macromolecules or polymers like RNA and DNA, which have the capacity of replication and reproduction. There are many speculations about how and when life was originated. Scientific theories about origin and evolution of life are based on facts and evidences. There are different theories about the origin of life. Before knowing about these theories, let me understand what about the origin of universe, because it is prerequisite for origin of life. Until unless we don't know the origin of universe, how we can understand the origin of earth and origin of life? In a book entitled A Brief History of Time from the Big Bang to Black Holes, the famous astronomer Stephen Hawking states that the universe was originated from an explosion of dark matter condensed at a place. This explosion was so powerful that the matter was spread in the universe, and different celestial bodies like stars, planets, satellites were formed. In this process, by some of the matter, the sun and its planets and satellites were formed. You might be knowing our sun and solar system is a small part of a family of many such stars and their solar system, which is called galaxy. There are many such galaxies in the universe. According to an estimate, their approximate number is 170 billion. Galaxies in the observable universe. So you can imagine there is the universe in which we can see, that is observable universe. Beyond that, there may be some more galaxies. Each of these galaxies has billion of stars. Small or dwarf galaxies have just a few thousand stars, whereas the giant galaxies have 100 trillion stars. Our own galaxy, called Milky Way, is estimated to contain as high as 1 trillion stars. After billions of years of Big Bang explosion, the planet Earth came into existence. After 1 to 3.5 billion of years of emergence of the planet Earth, the earliest form of life was originated in the form of prokaryotic cells, namely virus and bacteria. Gradually, unicellular and multicellular organisms were evolved. The main theories about the origin of life on the earth are as follows. First, divine or special creation theory. Second, spontaneous generation theory. Third, theory of cosmogonic origin. Fourth, theory of eternity. Fifth, theory of catastrophism. Sixth, theory of organic evolution. Seventh, synthetic theory of evolution. According to divine creation theory, life was created by supernatural powers. In every religious scripture, there is mythology about origin of universe, earth and life. According to Hindu mythology, the world was created by God Brahma. He is considered the God of creation. He created the whole universe. The first man was Manu and the first woman was Shraddha. According to Islam and their Holy Quran, the universe was created by Allah, the God. Allah begins by stating that the universe and planet Earth took 6 days to create. According to Bible, the world was created within 6 days. On the first day, God made the heaven and the earth on the second day. He separated the sky from the water on the third day. He made the dry land and plants on the fourth day. He formed the sun, the moon, and the stars on the fifth day. He made the fishes and the birds on the sixth day. He formed the land, animals, and humans. The first man, Adam, and first woman, Eve, was created by God. Buddhists do not believe in any such divine or special creation. Theory of spontaneous generation states that the life originated from non-living things in a spontaneous manner. This concept was held by early Greek philosophers like Thales, Xenophon, Empedocles, Plato, Aristotle, etc. In ancient Egypt, it was believed that the mud of Nile could give rise to frogs, toads, snakes, mice, and even crocodiles when warmed by the sun. Von Helmont held that human sweat and wheat grains could give rise to organisms. He placed a dirty shirt in a receptacle containing wheat bran and found that after 21 days, the gases from the shirt and wheat had formed living mice. Louis Pasteur, a French scientist, took broth in a long-necked flask and then he bent the neck of the flask. He boiled the broth in the flask to kill any microorganism that might be present in them. The curved neck acted as filter. If the flask with swan neck is kept for months together, no life appeared. As the germ laden dust particle in the air were trapped by the curved neck, which serves as filter. If the swan neck was broken off, the broth developed colonies of mud and bacteria. Thus, he showed that the source of microorganism for fermentation or putrefaction, such as for milk, sugar, and wine, etc., was the air, and the organism did not arise from the nutrient media. Thus, Louis Pasteur finally disapproved abiogenesis and proved biogenesis. According to theory of cosmozoic origin, protoplasm reached to the earth in the form of spores or germs or other simple particles from some unknown part of the universe, whereas the theory of eternity states that there is no beginning of life and it will never end. According to catastrophism theory, cataclysm or catastrophic revolution occurs upon earth from time to time, which completely destroys all organism. New organism then suddenly form from inorganic matter. Each creation consists of life quite different from that of previous one. In fact, this theory is a modification of theory of special creation. This theory is also not accepted. Then the next theory is theory of organic evolution, which states how new species evolve from pre-existing ancestors by the process of natural selection. This theory is also known as Darwinism. Charles Darwin, in 1859, in his book entitled Origin of Species, stated how new species evolve from pre-existing ancestors by the process of natural selection, which operates through struggle for existence and survival of the fittest. And in this way, only few individuals who are best got chance of reproduction. This process repeated in every generation, and after many generations, the progeny of distinct characteristics evolve as a new species. The theory of organic evolution got wide recognition among the scientists. Synthetic theory of evolution. This is a new theory, or we can say it is a modern theory of evolution, or we can say this is new Darwinism, in which essentially natural selection is a major evolutionary process. According to some scientists, there are two kind of variation that take place in organism. One is the ordinary variability observed among individuals of a species, which is of no lasting consequence in evolution. According to De Vries, it could not lead to a transgression of the species broader, even under condition of the most stringent and continued selection. The other consists of the changes brought about by mutation, spontaneous alteration of genes that yield large modifications of the organism and gave rise to new species. The new species thus originate suddenly. It is produced by the existing one without any visible preparation and without transition. So after knowing little about our indefinite space or universe, let me know the formation of Earth. As you know, or I told you, that our Earth is one of the planet among billions, billions of the star and planets in this universe, and our Earth came into existence just 4.5 billion years ago by accretion from the solar nebula. Volcanic outgassing probably created the primordial atmosphere, but it contained almost no oxygen and would have been toxic to human and most modern life. Much of the Earth was molten because of frequent collision with other bodies, which led to extreme volcanism. One very large collision is thought to have been responsible for tilting the Earth at an angle and forming the Moon. Over time, the planet cooled and formed a solid crust, allowing liquid water to exist on the surface. The first life form appeared between 3.8 and 3.5 billion years ago. The earliest evidences for life on Earth are graphite, found to be biogenic in 3.7 billion years old, meta-sedimentary rock discovered in western Greenland, and microbial mat fossils found in 3.48 billion years old sandstone discovered in western Australia. Photosynthetic life appeared around 2 billion years ago, enriching the atmosphere with oxygen. Life remained mostly small and microscopic until about 580 million years ago, when complex multicellular life arose. During the Cambrian period, it experienced a rapid diversification into most major phyla. Although more than 99% of all species that ever lived on the planet are estimated to be extinct, there are currently 10 to 14 million species of life on the Earth. Prebiotic chemistry. Before origin of primordial form of life, there were different elements in gaseous, liquid or solid state. How abiotic substances transformed into biotic form or cell during early state was initially based on speculations, but later it was established on the basis of scientific experiments. In the periodic table, there are more than 115 elements, but only some selected elements are basis of life. Chief of them are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, phosphorus, carbon. In the beginning, the crust of Earth was hot, whole atmosphere were unsuitable for present day life. There were continuous thundering, lightning and raining. Because of such physical environment, the chemical substances available were bonding with each other and making different compounds which were essential for life. For example, two gases, oxygen and hydrogen, bonded together and formed a liquid that is water. To understand prebiotic chemistry of Earth, let me see this image. See, there are molecules of water, nitrogen, ammonia, carbon dioxide, carbon monoxide, methane, and hydrogen gas. And in the presence of energy, these compound forming a new compound, and again in the presence of energy, these compounds are forming amino acids. So in this way, we can understand that how simple elements were formed, compound elements, and again these compound elements have transformed into different kind of amino acids, which are essential for life. And in this way, by this image, we can understand how abiotic components have changed or transformed into biotic components. The Miller-Urey experiment. In the 1930s, Oparin and Haldane independently suggested that ultraviolet radiation from the sun or lightning discharges caused the molecules of the primordial atmosphere to react to form simple organic compounds. This process was replicated in 1953 by Stanley Miller and Harold Urey, who subjected a mixture of H2O means water, CH4 means methane, NH3 means ammonia, and hydrogen to an electric discharge for about a week, and the resulting solution contained water-soluble organic compounds, including several amino acids and other biochemically significant compounds. To visualize the experiment done by Stanley Miller and Harold Urey in 1953, we have to see this image. This image is a diagram or diagrammatic representation of the experiment done by Miller and Urey in 1953, in which in a mixture of H2O, CH4, NH3 and H2 means water, methane, ammonia and hydrogen, the electric discharge were generated through electrodes, and after a week they got solution of water-soluble organic compound, including several amino acids. Prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Prokaryotes are essentially single-celled organisms. Such cells were lacking the nucleus. In the course of evolution of life, after prokaryotes or nucleus-less single-celled organism, eukaryotes were evolved, which having nucleus. Initially, they were unicellular, but gradually they evolved into multicellular organism. The origin of the eukaryotic cells is considered a milestone in the evolution of life. Since eukaryotes include all complex cells and almost all multicellular organisms, the timing of this series of events is hard to determine. Knoll 2006 suggests they developed approximately 1.6 to 2.1 billion years ago. Some acritarch are known from at least 1.6 billion years ago, and the possible alga Gripenia has been found as far as back as 2.1 million years ago. There were various mechanisms by which multicellularity could have evolved. For example, symbiosis, a group of function-specific cells aggregated, unicellular organism divided, but the daughter cells failed to separate. Sexual reproduction. Sexual reproduction is a biological process that creates a new organism by combining the genetic material of two organisms by means of meiotic cell division. Sexual reproduction is prime method of reproduction for the vast majority of macroscopic organism, including almost all animals and plants. The first fossilized evidence of sexual reproduction in eukaryote is about 1 to 1.2 billion years ago. Why sexual reproduction evolved and why it is maintained? The reason include fighting the accumulation of deleterious mutations, increasing rate of adaptation to changing environments, dealing with competition, or as an adaptation for repairing DNA damage and masking deleterious mutations. Ultimately, it is a means of genetic variation and provided way for biological evolution of life. Modern form of life. The Cambrian explosion is the term given to the time period between 570 and 530 million years ago, when most modern group of animals evolved. The Cambrian explosion refers to an unprecedented and unsurpassed period of evolutionary innovation in the history of our planet. During Cambrian explosion, early organisms evolved into many different, more complex forms. During this period, nearly all of the basic animal body plants that persist today came into existence. First vertebrates were evolved about 525 million years ago, followed by amphibians, reptiles, birds, and mammals, who were evolved between 300 and 150 million years ago. For further elaboration of evolution of modern form of life, let me see an image. You can see that how vertebrates were evolved into animals having bony skeleton, which are ray-finned fish. Then these bony skeleton organisms evolved into animals having four limbs, which are amphibians, reptiles, primates, dinosaurs, and birds. Further, these four-limbed animals are evolved into the animals having amniotic egg, and these include primates, rodent, reptile, dinosaurs, and birds. So in this way, the life has evolved from unicellular to multicellular organism. Initially, the life originated in water, but gradually it traveled to terrestrial life, and many terrestrial animal and plant were evolved, and gradually by evolution of vertebrates, reptiles, mammals came into existence, and under this class Mammalia, a order primate evolved from pre-existing animals, and this order primate has evolved into genus Homo. So the genus Homo first appeared about 2.5 billion years ago. Humans are relatively newcomers to the evolutionary stage. Humans diverged from chimpanzee about 7 billion years ago. About 2.5 million years ago, the first member of the genus Homo evolved. Our species Homo sapiens evolved about 5 lakh years ago. And anatomically, modern men or modern humans means we are, or our ancestors were evolved just 2 lakh 50,000 years ago. for further understanding and elaboration of evolution of life, we can see geological time scale, in which the history of Earth is divided into eras, epoch and periods. The oldest era was Archozoic, which was 3600 million or 3.6 billion years old. No recognizable fossils were recovered from the strata of this era. The Archozoic was followed by Proterozoic, which was 1600 million or we can say 1.6 billion years old. During this era, primitive algae, protozoan, mollusk and invertebrates were evolved. This was followed by Paleozoic era, which was 280 million years old and divided into 7 periods: Permian, Carboniferous, Devonian, Silurian, Ordovician and Cambrian, which was 600 million years old. During this era, the life evolved from aquatic to terrestrial. Amphibians and terrestrial plants were evolved during Devonian and Ordovician period, followed by reptiles and birds during Carboniferous and mammals during Permian. The Mesozoic era is divided into 3 periods, namely Cretaceous, Jurassic and Triassic. During this era, giant reptiles like dinosaurs, birds and archaic mammals were evolved. This era was 135 million years old. After that, Cenozoic era was started, which is still continuing. It was divided into 2 periods and 7 epochs. During this era, most of the species of present day plants and animals were evolved. Ancestors of modern man like Australopithecus were evolved during Miocene epoch, followed by Homo erectus, known as Pithecanthropus erectus, Sinanthropus pacanensis, Homo neanderthalensis, and their contemporary archaic hominids were evolved during Pliocene and Pleistocene. So, students, let us summarize what we have learned in this module. It is very clear from above details, or the details I told you, that the life on this planet was originated in distant past by the process of complex physical and chemical reactions in a particular kind of environment, in which abiotic or prebiotic material were transformed into primordial cells or unicellular organisms. Little more than a billion of years, the Earth was populated by the unicellular organism only. Then, by the course of evolution, organisms like cyanobacteria were evolved, who have the capacity of photosynthesis. These prokaryotes were evolved into eukaryotes and multicellular organisms. Thereafter, by means of meiotic cell division and sexual reproduction, the genetic variation was maintained. Life evolved into its present day shape, from aquatic to amphibians, reptiles, terrestrial species, birds, mammals, primates, apes and humans like B. Life have certain characteristics. Example given: mobility, sensitivity, growth, development, reproduction, regulation and homeostasis. The basic component of all organisms are same. They all have some of common chemical elements. These are hydrogen, oxygen, nitrogen, carbon, etc. Basic internal cellular structure of all organism are same. The heredity material, that is DNA and RNA, and structure are also same in all living organism. Today, because of scientific advancement, many impossible things are possible, but still we are unable to create life or a cell from the non-matter from which a cell is made. It doesn't carry the meaning that the life has supernatural origin. The reality is that after all scientific advancement, we are unable to create the environment by which the earth has passed through in its distant past, during which the prebiotic matter were transformed into a cell and started reproduction by means of cell division. Many times, the evolution of life is questioned by ridiculous objections. For example, which came earlier, hen or egg? They have their own logic to question the evolution. According to them, there can't be egg without a hen, and there can't be a hen without an egg. But answer is simple. First, egg came, thereafter hen. How it is? Very simple. First, unicellular organism were evolved, and from them, multicellular were evolved. An egg is basically a fertilized unicellular zygote, which gradually develops into multicellular embryo, then hen.